Hello, and welcome back to Myriad Caves CTM, a map by RenderXR. And today, there's a lot of things I want to be able to do in this map. There's a whole lot of different areas I want to explore, which is cool. I'm really digging the open world concept of this map. But we've done a whole lot over in the area crystallized and found some good loot. I had seen an area that I'd yet to explore in the back of that area that may even lead to other areas. And so I really want to go check that out before I forget about it. So today, we're going to start over in crystallized. So we're over here in crystallized. I'm running towards the back of the area, where originally I thought this had just been a wall that maybe was the back of the area, but there's actually more stuff kind of higher up is what we saw when we climbed up into the ceiling in order to get one of the emeralds that I managed to spot. And so looks like this might be a good place to climb up. I did have a stack of ladders in my inventory, and I think I can place some more blocks so I can just make this an easy place to climb straight up. All right, and we're up to the next level. These things make me nervous, so we're going to get rid of them. Also blocking line of sight there. I guess it's not so much the flowers as the little holes with the glowstone lighting for effect are trapping the zombies quite effectively because the zombies are silly and their AI doesn't know what they're doing. Let's eat some delicious fish. Oh, look at this. There are bigger patches of path blocks here that you can't place torches on. That might just be kind of a random brushstrokes coincidence, or that might be by design that it's going to be harder to place torches over here and things are going to get... Oh, be... blah, blah, blah. Get to be more of a... Okay, there's a bunch of creepers here. Let's... Oh, boy. Okay. I saw that time, that's the same creeper trap that we saw in one of the prior episodes, where there were creepers kind of coming up out of the ground. Fairly certain that was the same trap design. Okay, where is the skeleton? He's here somewhere. There he is. Okay, skeleton gone. We're going to pick off a few creepers. We're going to get the creeper trap on the left. Oops, missed him. Pretty sure I brought like two stacks of arrows, so I should be okay here. That was just a plant and not a creeper. There probably still are a few creepers who've already spawned over here, so let's just be ready for them. I do see one. But I want to try to get some light. Yes, right over here, that's the trap, okay. So we'll circle around, we'll kill another creeper or two, and then try to go destroy that trap. Did I say creeper or two? I meant or three. Obviously, I meant or three. You guys knew it. There we go. Creepers down. More light on the ground. Here is the trap. Cool. All right, this time I got the chance to see it kind of before I'd broken all the flowers to get a sense of exactly how it works. And so it just makes it difficult for you to see down here that there's a little staircase next to a little area where there's a bunch of creeper spawners. I don't see any others sneaking up on me now, so I think I'm safe enough to come down here. Break it, break it, break it, break it. Oops. And we're using our Duragold pickaxe, and so it should mend itself. It just did. Neat. I picked up an experience orb, and it just went zinc, and it went back to full durability, so that's awesome. All right, we also had a few creepers who were falling down on me here. Were they natural spawns? Were they... Nah, I think that's going to be from a spawner, because there is another one. I wanted to have somewhere higher up. Oh, I think it might be actually one of these. No, I heard them falling, though. It looks like there might be a trap there. That might have been from a creeper explosion. So where were the creepers coming from? There are different colored blocks like inside this tree, and I think it's mostly dark prismarine, but if it were a spawner, it would be kind of hard for me to tell from here. Let's do this. Yep. Get one bit of light up there. I just want to back off and look again. I don't see a spawner, but every time I've walked by there, creepers have tried to fall on my head. Let's try to circle around. Okay, hello, creeper. Let's see. That one's just one creeper. I'm never sure. Is it a random spawn? Oh! Oh! There's a loot box there. Okay, so maybe there's a wide area spawner on top and the... No! There's glowstone on top of that box. So I don't think... Previously, we've either seen a spawner on top and a spawner on the bottom, or a glowstone, or not a glowstone, sea lantern on the top and sea lantern on the bottom. I do see that there's a creeper on top over there. So maybe this tree's in the way. Let's go over here to witness what is going on. Am I safe here? I think so. Safe is always a relative term in one of these maps. So I saw a creeper over there. He must have walked around to the back side. There's a skeleton who's probably just a random spawn. This makes me very nervous. Because I don't like having seen monsters appear more than once and still not knowing where the monsters are coming from, especially when those monsters are creepers who've killed me more than once in this map. All right, skeleton was shooting at me from where? Here. There you go, he is dead. Still can't tell where the creepers were coming from. All right, let's just try heading up here. If I add enough light, it might not matter if there are hidden spawners. This wasn't really the way I meant to go, but it kind of turned out to the way that I went. Fortunately, I've got some feather falling. Oh, more creepers. I don't like the more creepers appearing everywhere. And silver light is starting to get worn down. I might have to, at the end of this episode or sometime during this episode, consider repairing the sword. I do have a couple of iron swords, just kind of plain iron swords that I found in chests. I don't have any iron left, but I do have a couple of plain iron swords that I could use to repair. I actually have one in my inventory right now. Did someone drop that? Someone must have dropped it, because I don't think I was... Maybe I was carrying this around? I'll have to go back and check the footage to see if for some reason I accidentally had this item in my inventory. But I really don't think I did. If someone did drop that, that would be the first time I think I've seen a monster drop an iron weapon. There's a lot of monsters who drop stone weapons, like the Smite 2 sword that I must have just gotten from a monster drop. So many things to wonder about. In any case, I should have just gotten a fair amount of light up here. So we're going to run through again. This time I'll try to light up this side. Trying to be careful about the types of blocks that I can actually place a torch on. There's a lot of creepers over there. I don't like the skeleton. Oh boy. Oh, I see. That's where... Okay. I saw the depression, the hole in the ground, and I originally thought it was part of a trap and then realized it was just where the skeleton had shot the creeper and the creeper exploded. So it's not as much of a worry. All right, I've been very paranoid about this area, but I haven't been able to find any spawners up here. So maybe these have just been random spawns, and maybe I've lit up so much of the nearby area that the area is just starting to get a little bit mob-capped. It's a possibility. It also seems to be the case that I see skeletons like sprinting around a little bit more than I think I've seen them before. And I think I was talking in a previous episode, I saw War say that Render had given skeleton slowness. I don't know. Oh, found the spawner. I was saying that I thought those trees, oh gosh. I thought those trees looked like they had different colored blocks in them. From a distance, couldn't see any that actually, oh boy. All right, you know what? We're gonna do a little escape hatch here. Go down over here. Oh crap. All right, hooray for Featherfall. Ooh, there's a loot chest up there. All right, that was a useful little escape hatch. Let's knock some of these down. I just wanna make sure I get plenty far away from all those mobs because I'm not sure who might still be chasing me. No one, the answer is no one. No one is chasing you, Brian. I'm actually running a little bit low on fish, so I'll top off on these. So inside the 2x2 birch tree stems up near the top, there were some monster spawners. And I think those are the first monster spawners that I've really seen kind of like way up high, kind of totally out of range of the player. But I think that's an appropriate kind of minor difficulty increase level change or something, because we have been getting better loot in this area, and so it's okay if there's a few aspects of the area that are also just getting more difficult. Since I did just see this loot pedestal somewhere over here? Where did I see it? Oh, all right, there's another. Oh, crap. Yeah. Fun box on top of that mound, because I saw multiple types of monsters. Okay, here's a creeper. Got it. I do not have a shovel in my bar. I wonder if I want to get one. If you just blow up. Great. That'll blow up all four spawners. Thank you very much. Yeah, so I guess I don't need the shovel. I can always use creepers if I have a lot of digging to do. All right, so there was definitely a fun box up on the top of that hill. Might need to go back to the ender chest to grab some torches in a little bit, but we'll worry about that when we run out of torches. Zombies are still dropping cookies and zombie flesh, which are not particularly useful, but I did just eat some zombie flesh just a moment ago. Okay, and so the fun box up here, which is it right here? Yes. Okay. The fun box up here. I hear the creeper, but I don't see him. Here he is. Okay. All right. I was kind of trying to do that crap. All right. Used my instant health 2 potion. I think that was probably an appropriate time to use it. I was intending to have the first creeper blow up the 4 spawners. He didn't end up in the position that I expected him to, and then the second creeper kind of came up and surprised me, and I was trying to be clever, and it didn't really work. We still have golden apples, so we still have those for kind of more healing when we get ourselves into trouble. But that is the first time I've tried to use an instant health potion when I've gotten low on health, and I'm very happy that I managed to select the correct slot in my inventory and actually, you know, use the potion, because I've previously failed at that, so that is a good thing. And I don't know how many of the spawners up there we actually successfully blew up. So let's go back up there and take a look. I definitely want to take out that fun box before trying to get the loot out of that little pedestal chest. The zombie I don't care about too much. I can always just, you know, kind of keep them away, and they're not going to do too much to me. The creepers are the guys who deal most of the damage here. I guess fire can be dealing a little bit of damage as well. But let's see. All right, the spawners are exposed. I think... Oh, no, creeper spawner's still here. All right, well, creeper spawner down. Yeah, there's really no reason to use the creepers to explode the spawners now that I have this good pick. For so long, I was trying to hold on for dear life to the remnants of my iron efficiency pick, because I didn't have any iron left to repair it, and it was running low. But now I've got the Duragold pick, and so I should not be afraid to use it pretty much for anything. Like, I can even use it, you know, just for, like, digging in a wall for a little bit, so long as I can get some experience to go and repair it. Okay, I think this area is safe. What do we got? I must have already looted this box. It says potions 1. I guess I looted this box. It wasn't particularly well lit over here. But this did allow us to find that spawner. All right, I've gotten very distracted. We were trying to go up to here. And so let's head back up here. Now we know where the spawners are located. How do I want to take out the spawners that are at the tops of these trees? I could use more ladders and just kind of climb the tree. I could bridge over to them. Am I safe to stand up here for just a moment? I think I am. So it seems like there, and probably the same height, probably on 4 trees in the 4 corners outside this loot box. I could probably, yeah, just climb some ladders and get up there. I've got ladders in my inventory. We haven't used them very much. Let's be the ladder guy today. There's a small chance that monsters will spawn kind of through the wall of the tree, right above my head as I try to do this. And if that happens, it's going to be very bad. Let's actually hit boxes. Place a torch, and I think it's probably right around here that the spawner is. There it is. Great. So there is one. I'm within range of the others, which kind of sucks. Actually, I'm within range of this one, but not this one. Okay. I see. So I can stand right here. No. All right, I'm just within range of this one. Let's see what this one spawns. It's probably skeletons. It is skeletons. Okay. That one just spawned. So we're going to run over here. We're going to run up here. That's high enough. Going to break that spawner. Great. And I think that one's a skeleton spawner, and that one I can't quite see from here. Let's break this one because it's already got some light. And let's eat a fish, because fish are delicious. Actually, I'm not fond of fish in real life, but I am fond of fish that heal 2.5 hearts in a map where natural regeneration is not turned on. All right, and then I want to get rid of the skeleton. Hey, buddy. And yeah, then we'll go take out spawner number 4. I still don't know where the creepers came from in this area, and I don't think for as many as I managed to see. Oh, crap. It's not exactly what I meant to do, but it worked. For as many as I could see, I don't think that it was just all natural spawns. But for the moment, if no more creepers are appearing, that suggests that I've at least got things well enough lit. And so, let's check out what we've won. Anybody sneaking up on me? No. Topaz legging. So previously we had sapphire, now we have topaz. Full set grants haste. And they have projectile protection. And a couple more golden apples. All right. I will take these things. Do I want to wear this set right now? I don't think so, because I've got better armor now. Previously, I did switch to some of the leather armor because it was about as good as what I have. I guess this does suggest that there's going to be a lot of skeletons in this area, potentially. So I might want to change my mind in terms of wearing this. But I think for right now, I'm not going to wear it. I'm also going to dump off some junk that I don't really need. So where else do we need to go? I came up here. Ooh, okay. Above me, that might just be anemones in the ceiling. Or is there something else? Let me try to get a vantage point where I can look around the back portion of this area and see if there's anything else that I'm missing that could be useful. Okay, I've looked around. I think that's just kind of one of the usual kind of growths on the ceiling. I don't think there's anything else in this portion of the area. So that does beg a couple of questions. One is, will this area connect to any other areas other than the shortcut that we found back to the dunes? Seems like the answer might be no, which is a little bit disappointing, but if that's what the answer is, then so be it. Hold the phone. All right, there is more in this direction I did not realize. There is a loot chest on a pedestal right over there. Just want to double check that I feel reasonably safe to stand here. Okay, not totally safe. And the other question is, where's the other emerald? I think there were 3 emeralds in this area, and I've gotten 2 of them. One was on the ice, one was in the sky up there with the green stalactite. And I'm fairly certain there was at least 1 more emerald to be found. Oops, okay, don't fall off here just yet. But in any case, there might even be some green back there, I can't tell. There is another loot box over there and possibly further to go, kind of like back over in this direction that I didn't realize. So I'll meet you guys down there. So the direction we need to go is somewhere over here. Rather than go directly from the ice, I decided I would travel across land. One presumes that there will be some kind of spawner trap somewhere near the chest. So as always, rather than run to the chest and try to see what's in it, we run near the chest, we light up the area, and then, then we get frustrated by the fact that there's nowhere to place torches. Okay, I'm gonna back off, kill some enemies. I'm about to run out of torches and good food, but I think, I just heard a creeper fall. That could have just been because we're kind of like near a little cliffside here. I was gonna say, I think this area is well enough lit that we could take a peek, because I'm definitely out of torches now. First off, more mobs have spawned. All right, there should be 1 creeper to my right somewhere. He's the main threat. Where's the skeleton? Oops. All right, fell in the water. Be back in a minute. Happen to see another loot chest in the ice over here. Oh, I see, just another one with the Frostwalker boots. Okay, that's fine. Killed off some of the mobs, so let's try to make 1 more run at this chest. Before I do, let me dump off some things in my inventory I don't need to be holding, because I am going to try to do a quick in-and-out job, which I usually do not do. But given that I'm out of torches and about to run out of good food, now seems like a good time to change strategies so I can get this done before I have to run back home. But if we kill this zombie who I can't see through the peony, then I think we can run over here and grab the stuff in the chest. Oh, crap. All right, it was basically the exact same stuff that I saw in an earlier chest that had some good food, had a couple of shields, which were actually very nice because shields have been very hard to come by in this map, and since they're made using iron, that's a useful resource to get more of. as well as some chain armor and a couple other things, some coal. So I know what's in that chest. I'm going to go back and resupply, and we will see if there is somewhere further over in that direction that we might be able to explore to find a location to get to another area. My mycelium at the base hasn't all grown in, but I wanted to experiment because I was pretty sure, and it is the case, that we would be able to grow large mushrooms here on the mycelium, which means I could try using mushroom stew as a food. It doesn't stack, but I have a feeling it's going to give a lot of hearts back. I actually haven't ever drank some mushroom stew in this map yet to test it, and so let me actually go take some damage and try that out. Before I take damage, I just happened to notice that this chest plate just has a sliver left. Now that I have two Duragold sets, I think maybe I will put these together, assuming that I can actually do that on the anvil. Can I enchant these things together? That costs 31. That costs 37. All right, 31 is acceptable. So I'm going to get up to 31 levels and put these together, and then I'll have a mending projectile protection for unbreaking two chest plate, which will be awesome. Use some bottles of experience to get up to level 31. Is this going to work? Nope, it didn't. So I actually need 32 levels, it would appear, due to that bug. All right, so now I'm at 32 levels. Let's try this again. There we go. Anti-projectile chestplate with mending. I took off my other mending armor because I wasn't sure if it was going to absorb the experience bottles, even though it was already healed up. But at this point, I now have a full mending set of armor, so this should keep me in pretty good shape for a while. I'm actually pretty pleased with that. Now I want to test how much mushroom soup heals. I'm fairly certain that armor does not take durability as a result of fall damage, so my plan is to jump down here. Even with feather falling, I'm going to take a fair amount of damage, and then we will be able to test how much the mushroom stew actually heals up. Go away, water. I was just using you to put out the lava, so in case somehow I've misjudged this and this is enough fall damage to die, I was not going to explode my stuff into the lava. Whee! All right, I'm down 4.5 hearts. And mushroom stew heals 4. That's pretty good. That's like an instant health 2 potion. Unlike the instant health 2 splash potion, it's not instant. I do have to take a moment to actually go through the eating animation, but that's a pretty good heal. I might carry some of those around in addition to stackable food. I don't know if I'm going to like it or not, but I'm going to actually try using mushroom stew as my primary food. It means I'll have to go in my inventory and switch things around a little bit more frequently. But if it heals 4 hearts, that could be good. I'm still going to keep the golden apples on my bar as an emergency food, because it's good to have an emergency food kind of ready to go as well. There's an Enderman over here. Endermen give enderpearls, and they don't like being in the water. So I'm going to do this. See if the Enderman comes back to me. Actually, I'm not sure if they can teleport. Okay, he teleported onto the packed ice, it looked like. But I think I should be able to just kind of sit here and finish this guy off. Hey, buddy. Oops, yeah, teleport away. Yep. I know, you're very angry. Hooray! Got an enderpearl. I guess I used an enderpearl once in the Drizzled Cove just as a convenient way to get around. Ooh, did he drop 3? Does this have looting? It has looting 3. I got 3 enderpearls off that. That was awesome. All right, this only has looting 1. I think I've been killing Endermen with the Wind Slicer before, but Silverlight's actually a better weapon to finish them off with because of the looting. So I have to kind of keep that in mind. I think I've gotten trapped under the ice here. Oops. I want to see if there was anything kind of like further on behind where we saw that thingy. And you know what? It's amazing. You can be in an area multiple times and like not notice something, and then all of a sudden you notice something. There's only 2. No, that's not true. There's 4, 5, 6. All right, I lied. I was going to say there's only 2 of these super, like, 3 or 4 wide tall tree pillar kind of things, and so I wondered if they were special, but now I don't think they're special anymore. These are the thoughts that go through Brian's head. Is there anything down here? I think it's just one of these, like, sea anemone kind of things that's growing underground. I keep calling them anemones, the transparent glass filled with the lighting cues, well, torches that make it glow, because I think they remind me of sea anemones, but now I'm kind of second-guessing myself as to whether that's actually the name of the organism that looks kind of like that. So hopefully I've been calling it the wrong thing the entire time. All right, basically, I'm running over this direction. I'm trying to add, oh gosh, light. to the area to see if there might be a path over here that goes somewhere or something else exciting. Ooh, there's a bunch of orange trees. I don't know that we've seen orange trees. Oh boy. Oh boy. All right, time to eat some stew. Great. Delicious and nutritious. And we're also going to continue running because I spawned a lot of bad guys over there, I think. And yeah, over here, yes, over here it's all pink and purple, and over there it was orange.